There you are. You were gone. Cut off. I got it. Just like you wanted, right? This will help me fight the Hiss.
Yeah.
Emily said that the hotline can be reached through the mailroom. This must open the door.
Thank you.
they can fly now. Great. They can fly now. Great. Thank you. they can fly now. Great. I have a feeling he'll be back. Let's stay focused. The hotline should be past the mailroom.
You're listening to America Overnight, mystifying the airwaves for more than 29 years. Thank you for staying up with us. Ghosts. We've had many callers over the years tell us of hauntings, voices, and other phantasmagorical phenomena. Today, friend of the show, Dr. Quincy Reagan, tells his story. Quincy.
Thanks. This is something I experienced recently while staying at the Chili Pines Motel in Macon for last year's suspicion call. I was in room 47. The night manager, an avid listener of the program, insisted I take this particular room. Now, the manager explained that years back, the body of a man was discovered under the bed. Inside that room border that the hotel was in, the body had been there a week, he said. Guests had stayed there, sleeping with the corpse and put below. They only found the body when housekeepers complained about the smell. Hauntings have been reported in room 47 ever since. I happily took the room. I fell asleep pretty quick, checking under the bed first, of course. No ghosts visited me, no chiller spots or flickering lights. But when I woke up, I found myself under the bed. It was dark and stiflingly hot. Luckily, I was able to push the mattress off and crawl out before I suffocated. The night manager was kind enough to find me.
There you have it, listeners. What we call ghosts take many forms. Quincy was brave enough to tell his story, and I encourage you to keep calling and writing whenever you encounter something strange, something you can't explain. Maybe you're seeing colors that we have no name for. Maybe your toaster is possessed. Remember, dear listeners, when no one else believes you, we do. America Overnight, we'll be right back.
Alberto Tomasi, head of comms. The hiss got him.
Alright, take this down. The situation in Cuba... Alright, take this down. The situation in Cuba has been evaluated by the relevant authorities. The mysterious illness affecting the staff at the U.S. Cuba has been evaluated by the relevant authorities. The mysterious illness affecting the staff at the U.S. Embassy in Havana was caused by sonic weaponry in the hands of a foreign power. Numerous personnel have damage to the inner ear, but most are expected to make a full recovery. Of course, the event also damaged their cellular walls, but we can't blame that on some stupid noise gun. Thank God no local doctors examined them first. Honestly, what are the odds an alternate item would show up inside a U.S. embassy? Talk about good luck, huh? So much easier to... Hey, are you still recording this?
The hotline can't be far now.
Thank you. Ocean View Motel and Casino. Dream Logic. The light switch cord. The door marked with the Black Pyramid.
Been here before? No. I've stayed at a lot of roadside motels across the country, on the road, on the run, under the radar. This feels like all of them, like something recognized from a dream.